So recently I put on my Instagram a Q&A session, and one question really caught my eye. So it was a question by a young man, I think he's about 19, maybe 20 years old, and he asked the question, why are modern men afraid to talk to women? So I sent him a message, I said, all right, what exactly do you mean? Do you want to elaborate on this? And he said, well, I feel very shy when I talk to women. I feel like a creep when I do it, even though it's supposed to be natural and I see it all the time. How can I become confident in that area? So that's what I'm going to answer today in this video in my lovely sunny garden. I'm in the shade at the minute because I'm a milk bottle. But yes, let's get into the video. So the first reason that I have for why modern men are afraid to talk to women, and I mean modern men in the sense that, you know, young men, young up-and-coming men, nothing over, say, 40, but I guess this content could be useful for that as well. So the first reason I have is that you were shamed during your early years in school especially. So this is quite common. I had this. This is how I know this. I'm sure Carl and the camera had this as well. When you like a girl in school, if you are, say, of the lower social classes, let's say, then if you let your intentions known, you will be ridiculed and shamed by your fellow peers. And this, at a young age, is very, you know, discomforting. It's not very nice. Because she finds out, your friends laugh at you, and you internalize that as, I cannot show my affections because I will be shamed for it. And I mentioned this to a few people, and some people, you know, they disagree with me, but, you know, if you've been through it, you understand that and you will resonate with that idea. And it is such a shame because if you are not brought up by, say, a strong male figure in your life, it's often the case that you are raised, this is going to my second point, by Hollywood movies. So you see, you know, the flowers, the affection, these gestures of, can I buy you a drink, all this stuff that works in movies, but doesn't actually work in the real world. Yes, it's nice to offer someone a drink, but in the real dating world of, you know, the school of hard knocks, this doesn't actually go down too well. It's almost like buying someone's time. Okay, that's how it comes across, is can I buy you a drink? Can I buy you something to keep you here because I'm not interesting enough? My next point is actually a lot more deeper rooted, I think, and that is the fact that most men are not the problem in the dating world. The realization that modern men are very misled and misguided in terms of social intelligence. So this is a big one for me. If you've seen things that I've worked in on the past, especially in my travels, I did a lot of work with young men to bring their confidence out, to bring them feeling a lot more masculine rather than, you know, weedy, creepy feminine. Which is, mainstream media would have you believe that this is a bad thing, that masculinity is bad, but it is the very trait that women find attractive, yet it is very stifled in the media. And I don't like that, and most men, if you ask them, will think that they are badly represented. Okay, so it's not the fact that we as men, as a species, as a culture, we are not creepy, we're not weird, we are just misguided and uneducated in social intelligence. Because we don't need to be. It's often easier in the modern world to go on things like Tinder and Google lines to say things like that. We lack that intuition of our own accord, something that was built by our fathers and grandfathers through repetition, suffering the rejection face to face, not just by text and then being ghosted and blocked. This was something that they had to face head on, they had to face the rejection, and most modern men don't have to go through that. If you put themselves through that, that's fair enough, and it will yield results. But most men, I feel, especially ones that I've met, and I'm guessing the guy that asked me this question, feels uneducated when it comes to women. He was shamed as a child for liking women, which is, you know, fairly common. He lacks the social intelligence to be able to communicate his thoughts and feelings properly, and he is brainwashed by the movies. Now, this is all well and true, so how can you, you know, how can you benefit from this? How can you take this advice on? And what I would say is the biggest piece of advice that I can give you if you are afraid to talk to women is the same way if you are scared of flying or scared of swimming. You go on a plane or you jump in a pool. This is the only way you're gonna be able to get over it. There are websites for this. There are gurus out there. There is me included. I will help you to get this confidence that you so seek. But at the end of the day, it is up to you to develop this social intelligence, to get over the rejection, to realize that there is nothing wrong with being a masculine man. There is nothing wrong with having a desire to meet women as much as the media would let you believe. And it's about breaking free from that culture, that idealist, that masculine shame and culture that we live in. And you can disagree with me, by all means, leave it in the comments, whatever you feel is appropriate. But that's all I have to say on this. You, as a man, need to embrace your inner masculinity by any means necessary. Get rid of this idea of toxic masculinity and face rejection head on. If you like this kind of content, at the end of this video will be a video that I made with my good friend Luca on how to actually meet a girl on a night out, which has proved very popular and yet very controversial. So I will add that on the end, and I will add the link in the description as well. Be sure to drop a like on this video, subscribe, all that sort of jazz, and I will see you in the next Thoughts and Motion video. Peace.